Hello everyone. Today I want to discuss one TLM making, that is teaching and learning material TLM making for mathematics. That is in the mensuration chapter, we can use this TLM to show and compare the volume of a cone and of a cylinder. We know that the volume of the cone is 1 by 3 pi r square h. The volume of the cone is 1 by 3 pi r square h and the volume of the cylinder is pi r square h. That means we can see that the volume of the cylinder is 3 times the volume of the cone. So we can make a TLM, that is teaching learning material, and practically demonstrate it to the students, where we can compare the volume of the cylinder and cone. And please remember that the height and radius is equal for both the cases, for both the structures, that is for volume and cone, the height and radius are same. So how we will do this TLM? So first the aim is to compare the volume of the cone and cylinder when their height and radius are equal. The objective is, in this assignment we will make cone and cylinder by folding chart papers. That is because we are making the TLM, so we will make the TLM by all the materials available to us. So by using chart papers we will make a cone and a cylinder and try to fit the cone inside the cylinder and compare its volume. So the theory is, the volume of the cone is V is equal to 1 by 3 pi r square h. The volume of the cylinder is V is equal to pi r square h. So we can see that the volume of the cylinder is 3 times the volume of the cone. Therefore, volume of the cylinder is 3 times the volume of the cone when the radius and height is equal for both. So you can see, this is the cylinder and this is the cone. So in this experiment, we will make the 3D model of the cone and cylinder with equal radius and height and practically demonstrate that the volume of the cylinder is 3 times the volume of the cone. So materials required are chart papers, rice grains, scale, compass, angle protractor, marking pencil, scissors and glue. Why we need these all articles, we will see later on why we need all this. So how to make a 3D model of a cylinder using a chart paper? In the chart paper, we will cut the chart paper into a rectangle whose dimensions are h and 2 pi r, where r is the radius of the cylinder and h is the height of the cylinder. Since the height of the cylinder h and the circumference of the top face of the cylinder is 2 pi r, therefore we need to cut the chart paper into a rectangle of the dimension h by 2 pi r. After this, the side of the rectangle whose lengths are h has to be joined and stuck together with the glue. This will make a 3D model of the cylinder. That is, this side is the height h of the cylinder. These two are taken together and they are stuck so that this forms a cylindrical structure. And in the TLM that we will make by using the chart paper, that will look like this. This is a cylinder. This is the paper model of the cylinder. So how to make the 3D model of the cone using the chart paper? For making the 3D model of the cone using the chart paper, we will follow the following steps. First, the S represents the slant height of the cone, where S is equal to h square plus r square. H is the height of the cylinder and r is the radius of the cylinder. So by this formula, we will come to know the slant height for the cone. H and r are the height and radius of the cone respectively. H and r are equal for both. H and r are equal for both cylinder and cone for this experiment, as it was said earlier. So we will come to know the slant height by this formula. Now, draw a circle with the radius equal to S. Whatever the slant height is, that will be the radius of a circle that we will draw on a chart paper, so that we will cut it out. Cut a major sector, that is theta is equal to r by s into 360. We have to cut a major sector. What is a major sector? This is a circle. As we can see, this is a circle. This is the theta. So the major sector is this part, where the area is major, and this is the minor sector. So we will cut a major sector, where theta is equal to r by s into 360 degree. That means here this theta is equal to r by s into 360 degrees from the circle. Join and stick together the two radii. That is, this is one radii and this is one another radii. So we will cut from here and this part will be removed. So what will be the remaining? Remaining will be only this major sector, like this. This major sector will be the remaining. So we will join this major sector. That is, we will join the two radius of this major sector. When we will join the two radius of this major sector, these are the those two radius. When we will join it, you see, this is forming a cone type structure. So this is the TLM made using paper. So in my experiment, what I did, I took R equal to 5, H equal to 5. So the slant height came as 7.07 and theta, that is the theta for the major sector, is 254.59. By using all these parameters, when we cut, we get the structure, that is the cone and the cylinder as shown. After that, what we will do, we will put some rice grains in the cone like this, and from this cone we will pour it into the cylinder like this. So first we put in the cone, and from the cone we put into the cylinder like this. So we will see that this cone, the amount of rice grains in this cone will fill this cylinder exactly 3 times. Hence, this proves that the volume of the cone is 1/3 of the volume of the cylinder, or the cylinder's volume is 3 times the volume of the cone. So this practically proves that we can see that the volume of the cylinder is 3 times the volume of the cone. So this is a TLM that can be made and done, and showed this experiment to the students using a video. Thank you.